Dang, it's packed.
Now joined by Andrea Carter, Sierra Burdick, and Isabel Harris. We'll take questions for Izzy first, and she has to go to radio.
Isabel, is this a different type of game to you? It seemed like the way we get the ball so much easier tonight. Did you say you did against them for games?
I felt like it's the same kind of game. I just had to slow down and focus on my shot.
Is it your 9 of 11 from the field, 7 of 8 from the line? Was that basically just it, slowing down a little bit?
Yeah, and working with Dean after practice and watching film and just really slowing down.
Can you talk about the shirt you're wearing from way back past, sure, what that means to you guys this day?
It just means a lot to us. Before we went into the locker room, you know, she gathered everybody and was just like, give her all for the woman who basically, you know, made Lady Vols. Pat, she gave so much to this program, and her courage and her fight, and for her to come to the game tonight just showed so much. It was a blessing towards us, so we really appreciate it.
What does she need to have that kind of game in front of her and one off your career? How do you play that well in front of
Just playing in her honor, you know, honestly, and just trying to do whatever I can for my teammates as well and be there for them. But I was glad she was there tonight to witness it.
Izzy, there were three Lady Vols, four Lady Vols in the front row coaching the entire game, especially the post players. Did you hear them all that day?
Yeah, I heard them all night. And I feel like at one point I had to recognize that they were there. So I was like, yeah, I got you. And they, you know, they listened back. So it was great to see them too. And they came in the locker room afterwards and they were just encouraging us and letting us know they're going to have our back.
Izzy, can you talk about some of the passes you had tonight too? It looked like you really were getting the ball. The passes were well timed. They were getting the junior in a really good spot for you to score.
We work in practice, and even in the past couple of games, those passes have been there too, but I wasn't, you know, holding my end of the deal. So I'm glad they kept on putting it in there and trusting in me to finish, and so that made me happy.
Anything else, Prissy?
Izzy, you've had some great games against LSU. Are you aware of that? Is there something about LSU?
They just make me happy.
Yeah, they're a great, their entire staff team, I just think they're a great team. And, you know, having Caldwell and their whole coaching staff back, it just brings so much energy to us because we know them and everything. And I think we just have a good game. Everybody does.
All right, Izzy, thank you. We'll take questions for Sierra.
I think it was in the second half, you had an open shot from 3-point range. You hesitated at first. And then you shot it, faded. Are you still at a point where you kind of have to make yourself shoot balls?
It's something that I'm working on. You know, I caught the ball right then, and I did hesitate a little, and everybody on the bench was encouraging me to shoot it, from the coaches to my teammates. And so, you know, I have so much encouragement around me to shoot the ball and be more offensively aggressive. And so it's just something that I have to work on, catching the ball and looking to score and looking to be more aggressive, not forcing anything, but just taking good shots. So it's something that's coming, and it's coming along. But, you know, my teammates have been so encouraging the whole time, and so they told me to shoot it, and I did.
So most players don't have the problem.
Right.
They're quick to jack it up.
It's
why is that? Why is it that way with you?
It's always been not really a problem, but, you know, offense has just always been kind of put on the back burner for me. Even in high school, I think the game where Pat offered me, I think I had 7 points when I was in high school. And so it's just never been, you know, I've always been a defensive player. And now that I'm starting to work on my offense and my teammates trust me and they're encouraging, it's just something that I have to work on.
Sierra, six assists, I think those were your first half too. Is that part of your plan early on, just to try to get them involved as possible, or it doesn't work out that way?
You know, I just try to keep the game simple. If you're open, I want to get you the ball. My teammates did a great job of getting open, using cuts well, reading the defense, and I just tried to find them when they were open, and they did a great job of knocking down the shots.
Andrea, Daniel Fallon had a heck of a game here a year ago. I think she shushed the crowd after the game was over at center court. You blanketed her to start that game. Was that an emphasis to basically make her a no-touch player?
It was an emphasis. You know, she wasn't no touch. We were helping off of her normally, but when she caught the ball or anything like that, we wanted to deny her a lot. We wanted to make things hard on her. So anybody that was guarding her tonight, that was an emphasis. You know, they have good players, and she's one of their best players. And so we didn't want her to get hot, because when she gets going, she gains more and more confidence, and she scores so creatively. She can get to the rim and finish through contact with both hands. So we didn't want to let her get going like she did last year.
Andrea, have you ever had a steal like you had against her? Reached around and pinned the ball against her, and then she was trying to drive me, just like she just pulled it almost off her shirt or something.
I'm really not even sure how that happened. Before, my hand was out, and then the ball was in my hands, and we just went with it. I don't really know what happened, but they didn't call foul, and I got the steal, so we just went with it.
Sierra, when the offense is going low, going inside like it was tonight, Izzy's having a big night, do you kind of forget about scoring? Because she scored really well in the last few games when Harrison wasn't able to score.
I think I need to stay aggressive, whether Izzy's, you know, hot or not. Obviously, if she's hot, we want to go to the hot hand. And the way Izzy, we know she's capable of playing, you know, you want to feed her the basketball. We've got all the faith that she's going to knock down those shots in the paint. We obviously want to keep going to her, but I think I need to be a threat offensively as well. I do admit I was looking to pass more this game. Just coming into the game, I felt I needed to get my teammates involved and just read the defense and work on reading and the mental aspect of the game more, because physically I'm just feeling a little down. But I'm fighting off a little something, so, I mean, but you got to fight through that. You know, that's no excuse. So you just got to keep playing, play hard, and really just take what the defense gives you, and that's what I did tonight.
Take two more.
Sierra, you guys are coming off of Boston. Respond back with a big, not just a win, but a big impressive win. Is that the mark of this team, is to put that stuff behind you and move forward to the next game?
You know, you want to learn from it. You want to learn from it, and I think we all watched film from it. We went back and watched the game, and we've got a lot of things we need to improve on, and we'll do that. You know, as we continue to go through SEC play, we want to take the mistakes that we made in Notre Dame and not let those happen again. You know, right now, we can't continue to worry about Notre Dame. We've got a tough SEC schedule coming up, and we've got to take it one game at a time, preparing for them. We beat LSU, now it's on to Georgia. So we'll come in tomorrow, and we need to really focus on our one-on-one defense against dribble penetration and get better at that.
Another question?
The shirt you're wearing, what does that mean to you for a game like this?
It's everything. I mean, Coach Summit has done so much for us, for the whole world of basketball, honestly. You know, you can go to other countries and they know who Pat Summit is. And so, specifically for us, I mean, just the fight that she had, the faith she had in us to recruit us when we were in high school, the faith that she had in Coach Holly to continue on the legacy of Lady Vols. And it's just, you know, she's just a fighter. She loves us. She trusts us. And so, she just sets a great example of what it means to be a Lady Vol. I think, you know, the fight, the encouraging, you know, to keep going. She does that for us. So she's how we need to be on and off the court. We need to exemplify what she's shown us as a woman.
All right, ladies, thank you very much.
Thanks.